remembering this kind of flow, that pattern of moving in the water, on the water, side to side. Okay. And then slowly roll it up. Can you energize the legs? Use your hands if you need to, walking up. Careful with the sinus pressure if you've got that going on. And then come up and then look over the shoulder, right, left. Try not to throw. Sometimes I'm guilty of, I'll throw my weight into the back and go and try to crack it. Try to just ease into the hips, shoulder. There we go. Focus on opening up the chest. Couple more. And then side to side, you can just reach, lean. Two more. Now take the hand and you're gonna cross over, either knee or foot. And then over to the opposite side, knee or foot. And then come back up, straight up, center. Fold forward again. Bend the knees and reach behind. Underneath. So I want you to go back and forth. Work your shoulders toward the knees. Keep walking the hands back. Maybe palms flat, thumbs out. Breathe. Bend the knees. Good. Walking hands out front. Inhale. Nice job. Flat back, halfway up. Walk your feet back behind you. And then walk or mountain climber the feet. Couple more. And then bring those knees down. Nice. And just continue that kicking back. Now you can drop into the shoulders and look up. I'm going to use that opposite knee for support. And just alternate again. Bring the knees under and push back. Now this is going to be like our forward fold, so hips can lift if they need to, and fold forehead toward the floor. Exhale. And if the hips are up, I want you to rock back and forth, massaging the knees, hips toward the heels, forehead toward the floor, try to meet in the middle. One more breath. Good. Option to sit in Rudrasana, hips, heels. And then modify by using a blanket or block underneath. Bolster is nice behind the knees or under the hip or quarter ankle. Walking out. Here we go. Toes turn under. Let's lift into down dog. Breathe. And walk the feet back and walk the shoulders forward. Lower the knees and hips. Bend the elbows. So I'm going to come all the way down. Contract the rib cage, rock side to side. Do that paddleboard wobble. And then we'll come up. Squeeze. Good. This time I'm going to pull back, but I'm going to turn the toes under, hips peel. Forehead on the floor. Walking hands below the shoulders and lift. Kind of fully back. We kind of got that breath going. Inhale, exhale. You can rock into the toes. You can move back and forth. Okay, and then four bones reaching forward. Inhale, exhale. So this is like cat-cow, just moving the chest in. Inhale, exhale, chest out. Inhale, back, exhale, forward. Two more. Bring the hands back to the hips or above the hips. Option, open up. Heel the hands to down. Four belt. Three, two, lean forward. And then come back to the hands. Lift knee. Down dog. Breathe, and you can move a little bit. Yeah. Do it. Okay, yeah. Just maybe move the leg forward, back, stretch, heel press, whatever we need. Right foot, step forward. One. Good, lift and lower the hips. Let's keep the movement going. Either fingertips, draw, palm, or lift and lower the hips, straighten both legs, bend. One more. Let's add the heel press. Come down, bend in that left knee, bend the right knee, and then straighten the right leg. Hips come back. One, two, forward. Step back, down dog, left foot forward, and then lift it lower. Option, go fingertips. Hammer that psoas in front of the hip. That psoas stretch. We're kind of warming it up by moving. All right, let's come down and add the heel press. Drop that right knee, bend the left knee, and then straighten left leg, pull back. One, two, push forward, slide the left foot back, stand up. Two, one, lift the hip, lift the tip heel, tippy toe, and then I'm gonna roll down to the hip. Okay, peel down. And up dog, exhale, get that out. Drop the shoulders, activate the triceps, back of the arms. See if we can just hang loose here and watch your feet wider than the mat. And then just kind of swaddle. Let the hips loosen up. So we kind of break up the psoas, break up the, what is it? The thing that got messed up on me was sacrum got jammed. So I'm kind of wobbling the sacrum SI joint. There it is, SI joint. Open up. There we go. Bring your feet together, knees wide, pull back, hips heel. Heart to the floor, elbows down. If you can. Okay, want to hold for your knees. Your knees are wide and your heels are underneath your hips. So remember we did the four bones here. If you try to do that now, it probably feels a lot easier. More movement, mobility in the hips. One more. Hands flow back. Open up the heart. Look up. Careful with the wrist. Make this about the spine. Breathe and relax in the neck. Little weight in the feet if you can. And then come on down forward with the elbows. Hips up. Toes turn under. Lift the knees and squeeze the knees together to dolphin. the feet toward the elbows. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Now walk the feet wide as the mat. Now push the shoulders toward the toes. Keep pushing, pushing, pushing till the elbows come off the floor. There you go. Keep the hips back over the heels. 3, 2, 1. Look forward and walk the feet wider than the hands. Hands, thumbs touching. And then squat. And then go back to that shoulders, knees. Walk the hands back. One more breath. And then walk your hands forward. Inhale halfway up. Exhale, fold. Inhale all the way up. Open up. Exhale. Lean to the left. Right arm overhand. Lean to the right. Look over the left shoulder. Left hand to right hip behind you. And then switch sides, right hand, left hip behind you, look over the right shoulder. Good, back to the center, reach up, we're gonna step back with that left leg, straight back. Anjaneyasana. Left hand reaches back, try to go way back here. Right hand, right knee, left hand back, 2, 1. Left hand reaches the right hip behind you, and then right hand reaches the floor. Drop the left knee to the floor, lift the upper body. Keep that left hand back there, face front. Good. Right hand back to the knee, right knee. And then push your hip. Left hand back to the leg or back of the leg hip. And left hand down below. Reach out, right hand up. Right hand, left hip. Good. Now as you heel press, release that right hand forward. Then come forward, back to down dog. Left foot forward, lift the upper body. Alternate. Right hand reaches back. Left hand, left knee. Right hand, left hip. Good, drop that right knee. I don't think I did this exactly right. Come down, I feel stuck, a little confused. So go left hand down, right hand, knee up, roll. And then bring it down, lift that left hand, left knee, open up. Now drop the hips in, just so as stretch, reach the right hand back to the either the back of the right leg or toward the back of the right calf. And then right hand down below. Left hand side, left hand right hip, and press the hip toward the floor, knee out. Good, and if you unwind, Bring that left hand forward and straighten that left leg. Heel press. And as we push forward, bring the feet back, knees back. And then press down. Paddleboard wobble. Good. Now come up with the hand. Feel another psoriasis stretch. We'll see if we can set this to maximize the stretch where we need it. Lifting the navel, belly. Drop the shoulders, drop the tailbone. If you want to go wide with the feet again, it helps. I feel like it helps drop the sacrum. And then go left hand out, roll to the left shoulder, and I'm going to take that right leg back a little bit. Careful. Good, back to the front, right arm out, right knee. Roll to the right, left leg kicks back a little bit. Maybe the left arm overhead. Stretch. One more breath. Good. Now when we roll back, bend that left knee, left ankle behind the right knee. Knees front, go back to sphinx, or go to sphinx. My left ankle is behind my right knee. You can be in tree pose here. All right, I'm gonna dive forward left hand, reach back right hand, grab your right ankle, hold on to it. Good, release. Switch. Bring that right foot behind the left knee. Bend that left knee. Reach forward, right hand back with the left hand. See if it can open up. Maybe lean to the right shoulder a little bit. Open that left side. One more breath. And come on back. Reach underneath. Peel it. Step back. Option down puppy or down dog. Woo. Feel that little bit of compression there. We gotta open that outside joint. One, two, walk the hands or feet halfway. Inhale halfway, toes in. Bend the knees a little bit and fold. And loop. One. Two. Good. Now use the bolster blanket if you need it, but bend the knees and bring the knees down. Sit on the heel toes. Kind of inside, I'm going to grab the back of my heels with my hands. And kind of roll the knees forward, walk them out. Go where you're comfortable, most intensity. Good. And then lean forward, grab your heels. Come up. Press your heels. Look up. Good. Forward. Into the belly. Round spine. Forehead toward your knees. Come up. See if you can put your fingers forward toward your knees and the palm of your hand on your heel. It's crazy, right? And then look up. Nice. Now go forward one more. This time we're going to reach forward, bend the elbows. Reach to the spine, behind the neck, below the neck. Stretch. One, release. Come back up. Optional. Tops of the feet down or hands back press. Shoulders back and down. Open up. Maybe lift the hips. Strong. down and lift your knees and push your hips in between the hands. Keep the legs up. See if we can do that. You got it. Yeah. And then walk the hips a little bit. Whoa. Feel it. Lean forward, reach forward, bend the knees, pull forward, or straight legs. Easy does it. We might be feeling the effect of that back bend. One more breath. And come on up, feet together. Knees wide, bounce the knees, just pick it easy. Kind of like an intermission now. Forward and back. You can go back to the four bows. Inhale, back. Exhale, forward. Let that knee hip roll. One of our goals is to externally rotate, create some balance there. Couple more breaths. Minimum amount, uncross and recross, go with that opposite leg, cross above, lean forward, try to roll the knee to the floor, put something underneath the knee, float in. Great way to open up the SI joint, kind of what our goal is, and then roll back to the bolster block, open the heart, let that knee drop. Notice if it's different, if it's more open or tighter, if the hips are rotated. There's so many factors. Do what you can to open it to its max potential. Then lift and lower. More breath. I like trying to challenge myself to do that. And then go to the forward fold again. Arm up, arms on the leg, shake them out. Let's take that bolster, then take a block behind the back. So I like using a block. And if it's on the low side, kind of maybe that's a good place to start. If you want to challenge yourself, I'm going to go to the second side. Yeah. I've been working on this earlier, though. I'm kind of seeing where my back's at. So if I go on the higher side, and then I drop the back of the head towards the floor, either side, wherever you're at, try to get the back of the head to the floor, and really open up everything in the front. There you go. Back to rally. Return the spine. All those dense muscles in between vertebral process, transverse process. More breath. If you go that far, toes or outside edge of that left foot into the right hip, and or just the thigh above the knee like you did in figure four. And then we're going to come back, and I'm going to go slow. And I've got the bolster there, and it's underneath my knee, so it feels tough. Now if I come back, find the block, maybe stay there for a minute, or deep breath, and then open up, please test the water. And then go further when you're ready. Feel that knee, hip open up. Get some symmetry between the right and left. More breath. And ready, slowly roll it up, roll to the side, careful. And then fold forward optional. Come on up, switch legs, grab the right ankle, foot, left hip, knee bolster, fold forward. Come on up, go back, check in, open up. That right hand spiral out. Let that knee drop to bolster. One more breath. Let's come up. Take your time. One more fold forward. Come up. Nice. Thumbs up. Stay down. And then fold forward. Good, easy coming up. Just keep tabs on that block behind us to bring the knees forward. I'm gonna go triang, knees bolster, which is bend the knee, heel outside. But you can also do this inside. And then I'm gonna shift onto that left hip, heel, and then right knee bend, knee bolster, hips heel, sitting on the feet. That's a deep stretch, but it gives us a little lift here, so when we go back, we don't have to push the knees so far. So if you want to go wider, you want to find that block, open up. There you go. Now the knees are lifted up a little bit, makes it nice. Reach up overhead. Dive up. Knees. Good. One. Okay. Come on up to sit it again. Pull forward. You can break free and reach behind you and turn this block on the end of it, on the tie end, that way. And back about, up to fifth. Back there. Now if you want a blanket, you can use a blanket on top. If you want to watch me do this, you can watch me. And I go back, I find the block first. So wherever the edge of that block is, I want to make sure it's not too low, not too high, not too low, because I gotta get the heart right on top of the block and lift the hip, and then press the knees forward, press the heart up, open up. How's it feel? Great. Awesome. Little shoulder stretch, little heart opener. One of my favorites. Three, just hanging loose. I'm actually dropping the hips, the back two on the spine. Two more breaths. And when we slowly come up, reset the hips, reset the arms. See if you can lift that upper body. Okay, go forward, fold. And then lower the knees, and then drop the elbows to the bolster blanket, and do the leg fingers, and then press your forehead hard to the floor, pull back. More breaths. wrist elbows or shoulders over the elbows, and then instinct is over the head, a little higher now, the bolster's under the elbow. Then I'm going to move that bolster forward and drop my shoulders again. So I'm going to go ahead, slide the elbows forward on top of the bolster, and then press forehead, shoulders to the mat. Point the hands upright or towards the ceiling. One more breath. Good. Now bring the bolster underneath the shoulder and then bend the left knee. Reach back with your left hand and pull that. I'm going to go for pulling the hip or the heel to hip. So it means I'm going to reach and press and then go like this. Let's blot out. And then go to the other side. Bend the right knee. Reach back. Hand, foot. Just do that. Heel, hip. Just do that. Go for a flexible further if optional. And release. Good. Back to the shoulder. Bolster. 3, 2, 1. Let's fly that bolster underneath the rib cage. And then both of us, this makes us like cobra. That's what gives us a little bop underneath the rib cage. Right at the base of the rib cage there. So if I extend the spine, I got a little bit of help. Pull the bolster. Okay. And then we're gonna bend the knees and reach back. Help with the wheel. I reach back down the knee, see if we can bring the two together. That squeezes the knees back and lengthen the upper body. And then go ahead and release. I'm going to do a little switcheroo here. If you want to give us heel to the hips and then let go. And have that push up, up dog, using that bolster. And then press back, but fly that bolster right to the knees. Right in front of the knees here. Good. And then go ahead and bolster. Now toes under, they're going to be fixed. So all I do is stand up straight and fold forward. Keep those toes where they're at. Keep that bolster where it's at. One more. Then bring those knees back where they were. And then we're going to roll. Walk out. And then just above the knees is going to be the bolster. Hips floor. Legs up. There we go. I haven't done this in a long time, but it's very useful to increase that stretch in the quads. So if I line up, and then I bend the knees, either one or both, observe the back, watch if it lifts, try to rub the tailbone. I'm going to go left hand, left foot ankle. Right hand, right ankle. Now come underneath that rib cage, so a lot of forward momentum there. So I press the hips and lift the legs, gonna get an extra stretch for the quad hips. So as one more breath. And release. Bring the hands back and do the up dog with the hips up. Bolster underneath the knees. Nice, gradual, steady extension. 3, down dog if you can, or child's pose. Lengthen, boy, boy. One more breath. Feels good. Walk over the bolster. Inhale halfway up. Exhale, sit on the bolster. Reach back. Legs out. Hyperextend the back of the knees. Start to pull forward. The pressure goes to the back of the knees. I don't want to go so far that it's damaging to the knees, but I do want to enhance that straight leg, because so much of the time we're bent, and I know personally I like to bend a little bit without even knowing it. Breathe. Just breathe and hold. Breathe and hold. We're opening up that SI joint, toes in. Breathe with like a gentle pull. One more breath. Come on out. Whoa. And let's speak together. Butterfly bounce. Power try dropping those knees. This is part of our practice of opening up those hips again. So if I get the lift and lower butterfly knees. Rotate forward. Yep. Use your can. Wow. Yeah. See where you're at. I'm gonna turn the radio down. Just get louder and louder. Reggae Monday. Lean forward, pull forward, heels in, pull your feet up, easy, there we go, One more breath. And come on up. Good. Keep those legs down. You can come down to the floor with the hips. Maybe step back for that bolster to be a little support there. Then we go side to side. Walk it side to side. Roll. Good. Circular motion around the hips. Let the feet move. Let the legs move. If they roll, you hear things breaking up, that's good, things realigning. And then maybe walk a little further each pass, so I'll walk out as intensity as I can take it. Imagine you're just taking this angle, this forward angle, side to side, and out from the leg. Breaking it up, breaking it up. We gotta do it. This is one of the many angles that we have. Okay, I'm gonna go to that right foot and hold it. And if you wanna go further. We're just focused on the breath. Keep it where you're comfortable. Draw. One more breath. each optional. As you get closer to the tailbone where you fold, the flatter you get, the spine becomes neutral. One more breath. Slow and easy. Nice job. Then bring our feet back together again. Legs back together, shake them up. Now you may feel a little bit like the knee inside is so stretched out. We're going to want to cross that left ankle over. Give it a hug here. Twist. Look to the left. One more breath. Right hand grabs left foot. Kick that left leg straight. Continue. Leaning back and then bend that right knee and bring that right heel to left hip. Put it across like this way. Good. Hope you guys can see me okay. Light a little bit dark in here. 3, 2, but I'm doing the IT band stretch through the hip. 1. Little wobble there. Now you're going to go ahead and open up that IT band some more with the cradle the baby. Bend the knee, left leg, grab the leg. And this is the night where I tend to go for some of those deeper stretches. You know what I'm talking about. Shoulder over the knee, over the shoulder, shoulder under the knee. There we go. That's what I was looking for. Go ahead and kick that heron pose. And then the left arm underneath the left knee. Like you put a backpack on. And then kick that leg up a little bit if you want to look underneath that right arm. Pin. Open up. And bring it back down. Okay. Let's go ahead. Take that right foot, left hand. Pull it up. Look back, reach back with the right hand. IT band stretch. Now I'm going to cross over. I want to do that stretch here. We didn't do the straight leg stretch. I'm going to go right to Ardha Hasta Drasana. Why not? Yeah. Give it a hug. And then we're kind of closing the inside, opening up the outside of the leg. So you got your adductor, abductor. We're on the abductors. Bring the ankle, knee, cradle the baby, one up. Let's feel the hip. Go ahead with the hair pose, or you can grab the foot and just kick it forward. You can grab the knee, kick it forward. If you want to kick it vertical, you kick it up onto the belly. Now, throw that right knee over your right shoulder, like you put a backpack on. Maybe grab that right foot with your left hand, and then just straighten the leg and roll to the right. Grab, open, all right, there it is. And then bring it back to center. That's a good. Circle it. Reverse the circle. go center. We gotta go to the back. And bring the feet below the hips. And decompress. You want to reach overhand, just pelvic tilt, tailbone, low back. Notice if this is like too tight or if it feels really open. Our goal is to get that sacrum to move anteriorly and posteriorly. Fluid, flawless, without breaking up or adhesion breaking up. A congestion. A couple more. We press into the feet, lift the hips, heel up, bridge. Chest to chin, hold at one. Two. Really, really feel the front of those hip creases open up. Now bring the knees in, grab the feet. Happy. Baby. One more breath. And when you're ready to release, you can release the leg step. You can transition to props if you want to elevate the leg, if you want to open up the heart, or maybe it's just the hip. Corded bridge. Wherever you're at, come back to your breath. Continue to feel the waves. From inhale, exhale, through the body. Thank you. take a couple more breaths. And slowly start to move. Move in a calculated way. Maybe checking in with those hips. Either twisting or rolling, maybe to one side. And on to the back up to seated. If you want to check in with more challenging seated postures, like Padmasana, half Padmasana, these are some of the poses we alluded to during class, and trying to get those hips open. Take a deep breath in, exhale out. Thank you for sharing your practice this evening. Happy Monday. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Namaste.